How to handle a non-reproducible bug. So this is a common situation which normally every tester would face during their day-to-day job. Basically what happens, sometime there are certain defects, it can be easily reproducible. Certain time some of the defects or bugs won't be reproducible. Now there are situations it happened that from the client environment, customer is able to reproduce the issue, but the same issue which is not able to reproduce in our test environment, or it is not able to reproduce in our dev environment, then what we should do? If any bugs comes for us, the first thing we should do is we have to go through detailed steps. We have to validate each and every step to reproduce the bug. That is the first thing we should, because we need to do a detailed analysis why we are not able to reproduce this bug. For that, first step we should do is we have to go through every step and validate it. Then the second thing is we should also test from our environment, both dev environment and test environment, to see whether it can be reproducible in any environment, or we try to mimic the environment which client is having it. And by going through the complete details of the bug, we may get certain clues, like whether any particular browser are they using, or any particular mobile are they using, or particular operating system they are using. At least we will get to know when we are reading, validating detailed steps which is in the bug. Then the third aspect we should do is, when we are not able to reproduce the bug, is we should gather certain screenshots from the customers as well, or logs as well, just to see is there any clues can we get out of these screenshots or logs from it. So by validating the detailed steps, then by validating the environment, by validating the screenshots and logs, then we will try to execute the same steps in our environment, and we capture all the data. This is including your test data, which is being used to test this bug, screenshots, application logs, system logs, and server logs. Everything we should validate and to see why this issue is not reproducible. Normally what happens, in first instance, that it may happen that we may not be able to reproduce by following all these tips. There we would be required certain patience, you would be required to validate, you would be needed more observation skills on the application behavior. Now, normally as a tester, you should perform all these activities whenever we say the particular bug or a particular defect which is non-reproducible. Then the next question is, what is enhancement defect? What is postponed defect? This is also a general interview questions. They wanted to understand, so what are the different status of the defects? So this is relevant to that question, which is what is enhanced defects or what is postponed defects. The enhancement defects are nothing but, normally if there is any new features which are added to a particular application or a product, if we find any issue there, we call it as a enhancement defects. Or if there is any changes made to the existing functionality, because of that, if they find a new defects, then we will mark the defects as an enhancement defects. And these defects normally we would be covering as part of the change request. It may happen that there are certain features which are not there in our scope, which is not there in our specifications. Still, we wanted to fix at least in the future releases. Because of that, we will be marking all these defects as a enhancement defects, so that we can take care in our future releases. Then the next thing is postponed defects. What is meant by postponed defects? The postponed defects are the defects which are nothing but these defects which will get fixed in the future releases, because they are very much minor and a trivial defects. It may happen that these defects might get fixed or might not get fixed. We will take a call at the later stage of the given release. What is defect triggering? What is defect triggering? The defect triggering, it is nothing but a scenario. It is a scenario or a condition or a behavior which triggers a defect. I hope you guys are getting. So there are particular defects can only be reproducible when there is a particular scenario has been executed, or a particular condition has met, or particular behavior of the application. That is the time there is a defect will get triggered. For example, a low disk space. So low disk space means there is no space in the hard disk for further accommodation of the information or data. When we try to add more files, more data into our disk drive, then it will trigger a condition where it will say your disk is full. And even in the second example is the defects which are related to search results. The defects related to search results, when we are doing a search particular keyword, then click on search button, then there is a trigger events happens where it writes to query from the database to fetch the record to display it on the user interface. Here, clicking on search button is a defect triggering. So what is critical versus blocker defect? Let's discuss first what is blocker defect. The blocker defects are nothing but these are the bugs or defects which blocks completely the entire testing with no workaround. With no workaround, if the completely everything is getting stuck, then we will call that kind of bug or a defect as a blocker defect. If the bug is not fixed on a particular time, then your testing will be completely altered and we cannot proceed further for further testing. Then because of this, there is a loss of services as well, because if developer is not fixed on a particular timeline, client is also will be waiting for this issue to be resolved. Because of that, they may also expect some of the functionality, some of the core things, or some of their application which not at all is going to work unless if they are not going to fix this blocker defect. Then we will try to understand what is critical defect. The critical defects are nothing but these are the bugs or defects which breaks the major functionalities of an application or a product. Testing is not actually blocked. Maybe particular functionality is breaking. Let's say if you have 10 functionalities, maybe two functionalities failing, still testing team can continue to work on the remaining 8 items. That is the time you won't call it as a blocker defects, but we'll call it as a critical defects, because tester is having a work to do. And also, if there is a functional failure, data loss, or a private data exposure, these are the time we have to log it as a critical defects, not as a blocker defects. Then we'll go to 31st. What is cross-browser testing? So cross-browser testing normally when we do is, when we have an application, web application, when we have a web application, where we wanted to support that web application across a different browsers. Different browsers, that means it could be on different operating systems, different combinations of the browsers such as Chrome, we have a Firefox, we have a Safari, we have a Internet Explorer, we have a Edge browser, and so on. With all combinations of different releases of the browser, which we are going to test, to ensure whatever the functionality which is working in the Chrome browser should work similarly with the Internet Explorer, similarly should work with Safari, similarly should work with Edge or a Firefox and so on. There should not be any failure in the application behavior. The application should behave across all the browser in a more consistent manner. If it is not working in a consistent manner, then we should log a defect and we should go and fix those issues as part of cross-browser testing, and we'll be logging defects also under this category, cross-browser related defects, so that developer will be fixing these issues in order to support across all the browsers. And what is end-to-end testing? It is a process of testing end-to-end of the application product. So we are not limiting ourselves to the testing a particular function or a particular module. Here we are going to test from login to logout, in between whatever the functionality it may come, everything we will be testing it. From installation to testing and as well as uninstallation, entire process will be performing as part of end-to-end testing. In the similar way, for a given application or product, we may have third-party integrations as well. So for example, we have for e-commerce application, we have payment gateways, we have a cart mechanism, we have a shopping cart mechanism, we have a credit card integrations and so on. There could be many third-party integrations associated with a particular application or a product. Then we should be able to test those integration. We should also test on terms of different network conditions. It could be 4G, 2G, 3G, LAN, WAN, and so on. Your application should be working seamlessly across any of these network conditions, and also your application should work upon any kind of desktops, any kind of mobiles, as per the your requirements or as per your client requirement or requirement specification. Then you should accommodate all different combinations of desktops and mobile phones to guarantee we are certifying the testing to validate across all these desktops and mobiles. And also different databases. Suppose if your applications is ready to support SQL, MySQL, Oracle, and so on. If your specification says that you should work on SQL or you should work on Oracle, then you should certify on Oracle or SQL or both and so on. Based on your requirement specification, based on the client need, your testing should also accommodate different types of database. And also, if there is any external softwares are involved as part of your installation or uninstallation or as part of the product deployment or as part of the application testing, then you should also accommodate as part of your testing. So what are the various severity types which are assigned for a particular defect? There are basically three severities which we normally assign for any given bug or a defect. One is low severity, which are more of UI bugs, maybe kinds of cosmetic bugs. Medium severity, where while doing certain operations, sometime application hangs, then after that it may continue to work in a normal fashion, or certain functionality doesn't work. That is the time you should log it as a medium, because application still it works, but it is maybe breaking on certain conditions, certain situation. That kind of defects or bug we will call it as a medium severity bugs and defects. Then the next type of severity is crash, loss of data, and critical functionality. If there is any of these behavior happens, situations happens, like crash, loss of data, critical function issues, then we will mark those defects as a high severity defects or high severity bugs.